Okay, what I want to share with you, just a short sharing before I dismiss you, would be a few months ago, I have some professional interaction with Dr. Chiu. Yeah. So Dr. Chiu highlight to me in a lesson, you want it to be effective, you need to address the macro level, micro level, symbolic level. So I use that and I try it out in classroom and it does help me a lot. And for today's session, you can see that for the macro level, we can introduce a demonstration, probably for the collision of the car. You can do a demonstration, a real-life demonstration to address the macro part. When you come to the micro part, the simulation will give you a very good micro level. You can look at the graph to tell you exactly what happened at micro level. And the symbolic level will be all the numbers and the equations that actually helps the student to understand better quantitatively. So using applets, animation applets, it does help you. Okay, but you must work together with a demonstration and all the other tools that you learn. If you want to depend solely on applets, I don't think you will work perfectly because there is not you can't find a perfect simulation that that is to the real life. I have visited the Institute of High Performance Computing, IHPC. So what happened is to come up with a real life simulation, they need a few months for the computer to run continuously. So this simulation will be good enough for the student application. And in fact, a lot of the industrial are using simulation because it saves costs and it saves lives. Why save costs? If you're going to straight away produce a prototype, it's going to be very expensive. It will cost millions of dollars. So what they do in the engineering world is they come up with simulation like animation applets. The engineer will go and test out all the variables, change the size and the shape of the object. And with that, they test it out to make sure that it works 90% before they produce the prototype and test it out. And this is what's happening in the real world. And the students are going through what the engineers are going through, putting numbers, test it out. If it works, they use it to understand the concept better. All right, so they are doing. We are preparing them for the real world outside there, right? Where we use simulation, yeah. So this will be a good platform using simulation and using applets. They will find a similarity, the connection to the real world outside. So I think with this, I would like to invite Dr. Chiu to give away the certificate of appreciation for our key presenter.
Jimmy.
Please fill in the feedback form. All right. I hope today's session has raised many interesting questions and really something for you to bring back to think about. And I think it's the beginning of the journey. Do continue to network with your physics colleague. Right, and we will have to form this strong network learning community. It will help us to grow as a profession. Right, thank you.
I think most of all, yeah, thank you for your contribution during the journey. Because I realize a lot of questions are being asked, and you should not stop here because of the time constraint, right? So please email as many questions as possible, not to me but to the three presenters. And then they'll take up for you, and they'll provide you online coaching also.
Okay.
Okay. So lunchtime is from 12 to 1. Okay. So enjoy your lunch. Enjoy your networking.
This is a training call.
For this one, okay, because we have some slides that were not done, I will point with you anyway. So just to end up with this slide, you can actually look at this thing called Adulab 2023. It's the same for people, Jimmy, myself and another guy called Damien from RJC, SRJC. So this is funded by NUMI. It's a two-year research project. It's about 100K. So I think because it's open source in nature, we believe the more, the stronger we get as a team. So we are conducting, we'll be mounting some workshops to teach teachers how to train the simulation on their own. But then, workshop once we tied up with we are inviting Professor Wong to come down. He has agreed in principle. So I need to arrange the date for him to come down. So once that is set, I will So once that is set, I will send a mail through the Master Teacher Network and hopefully or to in that email, remember to give me your email, then I can give it to you. Okay? And or informally, the worksheets that was shared, they are all in ICT connection, it looks like that. The simulations are in NTNU, you need to register. These are our blogs, and we hope that you can visit it because we do share our thoughts, our simulations inside the blogs. It's an easier way to share than to always email, which people tend to just forget. Thank you so much.
Maybe we should thank them for sharing with us.